Hey everyone, it's James, and in this video, I'm going to share a quick strategy to help you help students differentiate the difference between ionic and covalent compounds. So let's get started. Now, all you need is a periodic table, whether it's a gigantic periodic table like I have here behind myself. If you don't have that, you can project one up on the screen. If you don't have that, you can always draw a periodic table on your white or blackboard. And if you don't have that, get a piece of chart paper and draw on that as well. Now, what I do is I have the students stand up with me and then we point. Metals are on one side of the periodic table, nonmetals are on the opposite side of the periodic table. When they come together, they form the letter I for ionic compounds. Again, metals, nonmetals come together, form the letter I. Now, when I talk about covalent compounds, two or more nonmetals, so nonmetal, nonmetal, when they come together, they form the letter C. So again, nonmetal, nonmetal, letter C. It's a quick and easy strategy to help students differentiate between the two. I've seen students before just looking at their paper and they're like, you know, metal, nonmetal, I, covalent is nonmetal, nonmetal, letter C. Now I will say for the purposes on an on-level class, this is a method I use to teach the difference between ionic and covalent. I know there is a electronegativity calculation to determine whether a compound is ionic or covalent, but I don't do that because that's something that is not required for my students in this particular class. So if there's anything that resonated with you about this video and this strategy, make sure to like, comment, or share the video. If you have any questions or concerns, then make sure to leave that in the comment section. And if you want to continue to bond with James, make sure to hit that subscribe button. As always, thanks for watching.